I'm Dave Stowell.
And I'm Holly Hamilton.
And this is World Super Drone Racing. We're here at the UK DS Arena in Nottingham, the first permanent indoor drone racing venue in the world.
The arena will play host to some of the fastest pilots from across the globe, pushing machinery and technology to its limits.
In this series, we'll whittle down 24 teams to just one.
And they'll be crowned Super Drone Champion of the World.
Buckle up and hold on tight. This is World Super Drone Racing.
How did he manage that? Oh no! What has he done? And that is a crash and burn with a capital C. And could have lost the championship.
We are going to see some of the best super drone racing in the world, from the very best pilots in the world. Their skills will put you right at the heart of this extraordinary experience. And this is the only place to see the brand new super drone team racing format. The drones will travel at over 100 miles per hour as the pilots compete to be the best of the best. This is the oil rig. The drones will have to travel through here, spiraling at breathtaking speeds. It's no doubt one of the most difficult challenges on this entire course. It requires a combination of fine technique, concentration, and just a little bit of luck.
My name's P-Boy. I'm from Derby in the UK. I've been racing for just over a year now. I'm a doctor by profession, and I've been a doctor for about 7 years. And I took a sort of back seat on that. So I kind of do it part-time now in order to free up my time in order to drone race. I started watching videos of people flying through trees, and it was the most unbelievable thing I'd ever seen. I didn't even know what I was watching when I first started seeing the video. I got my first drone last year. I took a back seat on my job and just, you know, dedicated the time to learning the technology and learning to fly. With the technology being so new, I don't think there was many people out there that knew how to fly like this. It's a new style of flying. Even old remote controlled helicopters and planes fly differently. I knew I would learn because I had to in order to be one of the best and to race how I wanted to race.
Does that add some pressure, though, the fact that you might be one of the favourites here?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, of course. I mean, everyone's expecting us to do really well out there, and anything can happen in drone racing. It literally just takes one split second and it's all over.
So we've had plenty of last-minute adjustments going on here in the pits. But first up, we've got the green team. We've got Simon, Adam, William and Claire. Are you feeling nervous? Are you feeling confident? How are you feeling, Simon?
No, I can't wait to get out there and smash the opposition, basically.
Smash the opposition? That's some fighting talk. If you had a message for the rest of the teams right now, what would that be?
They might as well just stay home.
Are you feeling confident, Niley?
Yeah, I feel confident. We're underdogs, but we'll see how it goes. Everybody likes an underdog, don't they?
Oh, we love an underdog story. Who are you going to be looking out for today? Who's your biggest competition?
P-Boy.
P-Boy.
Show him how Yorkshire lads do it.
Now, have you got any serious fighting talk for some of your competitors today?
The best watch out in that corkscrew. I've been practicing that.
So after three races, the tables look as the following. The Jammers in first place, hotly trailed by the Scorpions, the Phantoms in third, and the Hornets with plenty of work left to do.
So for the Phantoms, it's
So P-Boy. First up for the Phantoms, it's P-Boy. A personal best on this circuit of 1 minute 18.6 seconds is definitely going to take something special to beat.
And for the Jammers.
The Jammers are represented by 3D Alpha. A great performance earlier today set the way for a strong start for his team with 2 of 3.
For the Scorpions, it's
Sonic Z.
A big rival of P-Boy, but certainly no admirer.
And completing the lineup,
it's the Hornets' Thorpedo, desperately needing to capitalize on their last result if they want to stay in the runnings. So our four marshals at race course side are ready, overseeing the action. We are ready for World Super Drone Racing. Ready, set, go, and we are off. What a start for Blue, taking the early lead there in hot pursuit, purple and green. Oh no, and Green's missed the gate. How costly was that? Over the oil rig. Excellent agility and speed here, but it's gonna come down to who can keep their concentration. Can he avoid a mistake? The action continues, and it's a wipeout! What news for P-Boy? A turn of events, and you see the concentration on the young man's face. 45 seconds in. Oh no! What has he done? What an opportunity here. It's Sonic, Z, and P-Boy, the two men, two rivals, and only seconds apart. Scorpion Z and P-Boy continue to duke it out. It's one-on-one. Who will get that big 10-point win in race number four? The solo performance, onboard footage here from P-Boy. Look at the way he turns. And this will be a fight to the end. P-Boy, can he hold it together? Scorpion Z, hot on the tail, taking the lead. P-Boy right back into first place again. Scorpion Z and P-Boy continue to duke it out. It's a win for P-Boy. Scorpion Z takes second place. What a performance.
We were chatting earlier in the pits about being the favorite. Has that put some pressure on this, or do you feel like it's actually helped you?
I feel it's helped me now. Definitely getting that first race out of the way and knowing it's a win is definitely built my confidence. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Brilliant. One out of the way, plenty more to go. Good luck and thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
After the individual race, a perfect performance for 10.7 for second with the Scorpions, the Jammers and Hornets with two big crashes have accrued zero. So the fourth race is in the books. The Phantoms in first, hot on their tail. The Scorpions, the Jammers catching up nicely, and the Hornets plenty of work to do. It's all teed up nicely for the Phantoms with a narrow first place lead. Here's Twister, and he knows the pressure is on as he leads the relay. And Mad Rascal also knows the Jammers need a big performance from him and his team if they want to finish on top. First up for the Scorpions is Briska. They are in a great position to seize the day with 26 points in the pot. And completing the starting lineup, first up for the Hornets, it's Chiquiza. They need a performance and a half. World Super Drone Racing is the highest level of problem solving under pressure, and what better way to do it than the big relay face-off. Our officials are ready. Here in World Super Drone Racing. Ready, set, and we're off. A great start again for Blue, but no. The referee here has called a false start. Taking a look at the replay, definitely off the line a little bit too soon. Will we see a penalty? And a brief consultation here, and indeed, I think they're going to penalize here. Under the rule set, they'll only have one chance at a start. Again, catastrophic error there for the Jammers. The pressure is on for Mad Rascal. Again, a reset. Ready, set. And it's good. Off the starting line again. Man, the Jammers are hot today. And the Phantoms are seriously going to have to make up some time here with a very, very late get-go off the podium. Red leading here. Hornets looking good. Scorpions in hot pursuit. The Hornets dipping and rolling here. What skill and technique. This was the performance we knew that Chiquiza had to deliver in the first stage of the relay. Missed gate there by Green. The Scorpions doing what they can. And our first changeover is underway. Great stuff. This is surely one of the most difficult aspects of this contest. Liftoff again. The Phantoms now catching the lead here. It's all about that time change, folks.
but it's touchdown again, a swap over. Quick change here. Back on board with Green. Look at this, excellent maneuvering here, working underneath the gates, and the Hornets doing what they can to try and catch up. The Hornets on board now, looking really solid here, but oh no! The Hornets are out! The Hornets are out! What a mistake, and that has cost them the relay, folks. And it's a classic matchup here in the World Super Drone Racing Series. It's the Phantoms taking on the Scorpions. The Phantoms back in first place. What a result it would be. Just seconds to go, racing towards the finish line. A good 5 or 6 second lead here for the Phantoms. And it's a win for the Phantoms.
So well done, guys. That was the relay and you won. How do you feel?
Amazing. Feels really good. We took a bit of a hit in the first lap, but then thankfully Jake made up for it with a great second lap and we've done really well. So yeah, super chuffed.
And you won't have done anything like that before. That was your first relay as a team.
Yeah, definitely. It was a bit different to what we're used to, but it was awesome and we're super happy.
So some of your teammates have been doing this for several months now, yeah. Some of them years. I mean, what advice did they give to you beforehand?
Just stay focused and just make sure I keep my eye on the ball and just do the best that I can possibly do, really.
Really well done, Claire. It was a great race. Really enjoyed it. And honestly, first time. Really well done.
The Phantoms are hot today. First place finish. Scorpions doing very well indeed in second, and the Jammers and Hornets cannot get off the ground after two crashes. It was certainly close going into it, but after the fifth race, the Phantoms have increased that lead by 4 points. Scorpions second place, Jammers in third. The Hornets have yet to get on the podium. The bright lights shine today in Nottingham. For that team, the Phantoms, your winners here in the World Super Drone Racing.
Well, thanks for your company. Hope you've enjoyed everything with us today.
I know we have, and there have been more twists and turns than a gravity gate today. It hasn't been easy for some of our pilots, has it?
No, it's certainly been a challenge. Do join us soon, though, for some more World Super Drone Racing. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.